the short commercial break that we just had, we still have Latigo to help us understand how to fight the termites in our homes. Latigo.
Yes, please.
You've been telling us on how these ants and termites form a colony, how they operate, how they carry those loads, how they destroy our homes.
Mm.
Let us look on how we can fight them.
There are so many various ways that we can prevent this from happening, and I can mention just a few. One, because I told you ants eat anything. Talk about bricks, talk about cement and all that. We have what we call the ant dust. Ant dust is another way of controlling. It's just like a spray. As you go and acquire insecticides, you can ask for what we call the ant dust spray. This can be used on walls. These days we find ourselves building using open bricks that we do not apply cement and other things, yes. So you can apply that ant dust to prevent the ants from eating up those bricks because they will eat them. Then there are those that have big homes like where we are, and they have to have outside kitchens that use firewood. So we would also further advise you not to pile so much wood in one area for a long time, because as you leave them there, they become breeding grounds for these ants. Then there are other people that love nature. We plant a lot of flowers, plants, and shrubs, and later on they become almost bushes. So let's not plant them so close to the wall or so close to the structures, because if you do, you're also attracting those ants from eating up the structures. So initially, I think those can take you through, and the rest you can try to consult the professionals one-on-one, and they can take you through. But if you are able to avoid having the shrubs next to the structures, you are able to also control the fact that you're piling so much wood or firewood in one area for a long time. You're also getting rid of them. You can also use insecticides. Like I've told you, there is what we call anti-dust sprays that you can also use. Please make use of them. You will not find these ants or termites invading your homes or your other structures. This can be able to help out in preventing them.
So for the ones that have dust bins.
Yes.
Outside, they dig, they keep dumping.
Mm.
Yet you know, okay, we've just learned that these termites or ants come looking for what to eat.
Mm.
Communicate to the other army that is behind.
Yeah.
That please come, there is a goodie here. So how are those ones supposed to treat their dustbins?
One, we should avoid constant leakages. Leakages could be water drops.
Mm.
Or you find places that normally stagnate with a lot of water. It may not be seen liquid like it's there, but the place is always wet. This means that for those with dust bins, they should ask the professionals, the service providers, to provide them with, these days we have what we call covers, those polythene bags, they are big. So you sort your rubbish, wet rubbish alone, and then the dry rubbish alone, tie them in the cover, and then dump them into the dust bins. This will control a lot and will prevent these things from coming to look for that kind of food, because they will always find these things are sealed and they're not put together. But so long as you're just having one thing, jumula, you bring water, pour there. You bring other foods that have remained and you've been washing, then you pour. So having those still invites them continuously. So we can only try to avoid by separating the rubbish. Have wet rubbish alone or wet garbage sorted alone. Tie in the cover, dump it. Then have the other also done the same, dump it together. I think that can help them out critically well.
For the ones that say, no, for us we are sorted because we have our bricks that are burnt, clay, what, or concrete bricks, what do you advise them?
They should never forget the anti-dust that I mentioned earlier. These things, prevention is better than cure. So anytime that you still feel you want to have a nice life into your structure, take caution of these preventive measures. Get the anti-dust spray. Once in a lifetime, if you have workers in your premises, let them make use of those sprays. As they are cleaning, spray into those corners, spray into the dark areas, those that seem to be molding, those that seem to be wet, avoid the leakages. With that, you are going to find yourself not even having any close chance of seeing the termites invading your premises or structures. Yes.
in an event where one of us sleeps and wakes up when termites have already invaded, how do they fight?
First of all, that is a shock, because some of them actually, some of the people are woken up by the bite, because they think you come, climb and cross through, and then they don't bite that they want to hit you, but as you're turning, they feel like they are being attacked also, and they start hitting you. As one hits, you find they are already scattered everywhere. So the first thing that you can do to get rid of them is, basically, since they are attacking in the night, you need to have a torch. If you don't have light, normal light, you need to have a torch, because you cannot fight what you can't see. Then when you see them there, that they are really have attacked, you don't have any insecticide within, all that we can do is get some water. Could be warm water or hot water. Use it as a splash and sweep. They will die or they will disappear. But if you can also follow the trail closely, because normally as they attack, it is a trail. It's not just one, two, three. You find there's a queue of them coming in. So follow the lead and find a way of blocking that entrance. Then one, this takes me to another preventive that I'd forgotten about. We should leave the ventilation open, not clogged. Certain times, you know, with a lot of deco coming in, you find the ventilators, everything has been fitted there. So many things have been fitted there. Now, as you do that, you're also inviting these things to come in. Actually, so many houses that we go to, we find that termites or ants have already built somewhere into the ventilators there. It's because they have tried to pack so many. So you should let the ventilation be free. Let it be free so that you don't provide a breeding ground for these termites or ants. Okay? So once that is done, I think you'll be free from these things.
You talked of the ant dust to be used in spraying and prevention of termites. Isn't it harmful to our health?
Okay. Now, I should say too much of anything is always bad. There's nothing that destroys another creation that is not really harmful to human. But we should say it's quite human friendly if used the right way. All right? So basically, as we are applying the ant dust, we are looking at applying it on structures, on walls, okay, on pillars, onto those key areas that are not so exposed that we can find the ants coming through. So they are also almost no-go areas for any other person to come and touch and play around with them. So this still creates and gives us safety that they are not going to be harmful, unless taken on with an intent that you want to destroy your life. But for them doing their right work to be done, like applying onto the structures, on the pillars, on those key areas that I've mentioned, I think we are good to go. They are human, life friendly.
One thing that I've always known since I was little is that you can't fight the termites unless if you dig, you look for the anthill, dig it up and take out that queen termite.
Yes.
Now, by you advising us that we just spray, aren't these ones continuing to come every other day, causing us discomfort?
I will gladly tell you that once again, thanks to the technology and the new discoveries coming in now and then, every now and then, more land personnel come up with solutions. Gone are the days where I used to look for maybe a hoe, an axe, whatever you can use, any kind of material to go and dig out the queen ant. So currently, if you cannot access the queen ant, does it mean that you're going to let these things continue disturbing you? No. That's when I told you that you're going to look for a professional to come and apply what we called an ant bait. Okay? Now, this ant bait, as I mentioned earlier, it is one that these particular kind of ant ornaments that come and ferry food to take to the queen ant will now not secrete that hormone, but they will instead be tempted to carry and take to where the queen is and where the others are, and the whole of them will eat or will feed on that. Now, them feeding on that, you're going to find the queen ant dying. Now, once the queen ant is dead, that colony ceases to stay. They will all disappear, they will all scatter and find other means of survival, but they will have died also. Mm-hmm. So that means you're going to get rid of that anthill or that kind of colony without even digging. Because remember, also digging it's for the olden days that you are digging, you're creating a lot of, you're going to now call into another kind of work for landscapers, okay, to come and deal with your terrain because you've created unnecessary kind of, you know, terrains within someone's compound. So we may not necessarily need to dig, but we come in with other solutions that are so digital that you're going to find this thing destroyed without even damaging others.
Now I'm interested in that bit.
Yes.
Of other solutions that are digital.
Mm-hmm.
Do you mind mentioning some of the digital methods of fighting an anthill?
I just made it sweet, seem sweeter, but it's the bait I'm talking about. Okay? Just the same way I mentioned earlier on that you see a fishmonger goes onto the lake to fish, gets his hook, he has to apply something to attract the other fish to come and eat. But the intention is for not for to feed the fish, but to catch it. So as to it comes to really have it, they eat it. So this is something we are also going to apply. These things will carry all this load, take to their colony, and they will celebrate. They have gotten something so sweet. It's something for all of them. They will all come and feed. They take to the queen. They will all eat and die nicely without you digging and all that. And you see this will not happen again. So these other leads will start now dying completely. That's the same way that we did around here. So you will see all those, you will see these other funny things remaining on the walls. Those are trails that used to be when the queen was still active. But after the queen dying, you now can't see. You asked me also more about how you can find out that you have those things invading you. Take clear note of those funny holes, small holes you see on houses.
What kind of holes?
They could be small kind of holes, whether you have a tiled house or you have a cemented house. But within or on the floor, you may see a small hole somewhere. Normally they are created around the hinges of the doors. Mm. Okay, as you're going into another room, you find there are some holes there, even some dust that is created. Those are ants trying to create something. So once you see that, we treat them as soon as immediately. Because the moment you kill them and they don't return to take a report that things are good, the others will not come.
You're safe.
Yes, because the moment they find something sweet, they secrete the other hormone I talked about. So the others will come following that scent.
Do we have some buildings
yeah.
or structures that can really not be invaded by termites?
Are preventive measures being taken? For example, there are some places that do not have the following. They do not have what we call flooding. Should we use the word flooding? I should say that kind of water that is always there to clog the areas. Secondly, they have used little of normal wood, okay? We find sawdust being used as to make doors, make floors, make windows. They have used minimum of that because actually that's why you see nowadays most of the construction is done or made using aluminium. So such a building may find us have no ants at all coming in because they will have nothing to feed on. You cannot also eat one meal, else you will not eat cement. So certain changes want to come in. So this is when we are going to devise means and embrace the use of such kind of work, embrace the use of aluminium and minimize the use of maybe wood if you find that you are in areas that are always infested with ants.
So what is the main cause generally for these termites and ants?
Thank you. The general or the commonest one that I can use or other hand I can mention is one, water, and then much use of wood or timber. Then lastly is a lot of garbage, or you can in a common language you can say rubbish. You cannot fail to go and identify some termites somewhere. If you're going to a rubbish pit, you'll find them there. You find the trails there. Places that are always clogged having that kind of wet environment, like, you know, you find them there because that is soft grounds for them to enjoy. Now, wood, carpentries, those places, it's too hard for them to avoid. So we need to, if you are finding yourself falling under that category, always use those preventive measures even before you start constructing. That's when the sawdust comes in. That's when the ant kind of spray comes in, okay? Which is going to help you overcome the infestations of these ants.
So what natural remedies or remedy can one take to fight the termites permanently?
All right. We have some plants that we also can apply. For example, people who love flower gardens around homes, you find someone has a flower bed, they can plant any kind of plant that they do want, but they get irritated by these termites coming and meeting their things. So we have certain plants that we can mix within our gardens that will help out in killing the other funny insect I talked about earlier on, the aphids. Because this aphid is one kind of pest that flies and scatters on any kind of plant that it sees. But in it coming to eat something onto your plant, it is secreting the other hormone, which is honey-like, okay? And this is one of the delicacies of these ants. All right. So meaning that, what are you going to do? You'll be able to plant these other plants, mixing them or mixing them within the flower bed to help you chase away the aphids. Now, as it chases away the aphids, it is also chasing away the ants, because the ant will not stay where it is not going to eat.
So what is the family group of those plants that can actually fight termites?
Now you're taking me back to biology. I want me to talk about Biden's pilosa, all of those kind of things. No, I'm not going to mention that. But all I can tell you is that if one is interested in having those plants, at least that is also now our secret that we are going to stay with. That's the same way KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken,
he has
about 12 recipes, but the 10, he was able to give them out, and the 2 are his. No wonder wherever you go, find one Kentucky Fried Chicken, test the same. Go to Dubai, go to Uganda, go to Qatar, the same test.
So how long does it take one to fight the termites permanently?
Let's say they have invaded you and it's really tense, you really have them. We shall give you a period of 3 months. Now, once we take on, for example, a contract like that, we do not come once. This thing of saying that, let's come and do this, we do our treatment and go away. That's not it. We are going to do this thing for 3 months.
Who is to blame? For instance, where we come, I buy a plot,
yeah.
I invite my architects, I get my engineers, give them a site, and they don't get back to me that, you know what, boss, is an issue. Who is to blame in such cases?
I think nobody is supposed to be blamed on this. Because now, when you're calling your site engineers, they have come to give you a structure, positioning, and the beauty, how it's going to come out, right? Now, then you, the owner, all you want is also to see your beautiful building coming up and already structured and displayed. So meaning that everyone is responsible. Sometimes it gives you credit, even when you go an extra mile and do certain things that you have not been told to do, if it doesn't cost you a thing. If a candle loses nothing by lighting another candle.
Exactly.
Mean that if you'll be given a site to just come and maybe paint, and then you see a nail somewhere that is standing and then you let it lie, it is not only saving you but also saving another life. So I would ought to think that everybody should carry on the responsibility that if you are on a site of someone and you notice one of those things I've talked about, feel free to share with any other. Then that's when they will contact the professionals to come and see how tense or how a loss of this can be, and then get rid of it before it's too late for them. Please make use of the professionals. Everything that you see on earth has those that have taken time to study and also given their time to come and serve you so that you have a free environment. So I would say that relax, because we have got this.
This is the effect that termites can cause on your building. Don't wait for this. Don't wait to lose money. Don't wait to lose your beauty of your home. We have heard from an expert. He has advised us on what to do. Please adopt that so that we have a beautiful and comfortable living. This is the Homes and Construction Affairs Show. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Until next time.